Hi everyone, welcome back to Class of Education online YouTube learning channel. So this is Kaurav and today we will be taking a very popular topic in news, that is angel tax. So let's start with angel tax. We will take some questions and then we will see how it affects these startups. Okay, now what actually the angel tax term mean? So it is an income tax payable on capital raised by unlisted companies. Please remember, it is an income tax payable on capital raised by unlisted companies. These companies shows these share prices at a raised value greater than book value. What actually the book value of a share means? It is actually the difference of assets minus liabilities divided by number of shares. And from this particular observation, we can say that this is the book value of the share. So when we say that a company shows the share prices at a raised value greater than book value as compared to fair market value, it will get a margin of earning. Okay, the raised margin is considered as income and taxed accordingly. We will be seeing some provisions where the exemption limits are there, but terminology says that income tax payable on capital raised by unlisted companies when these companies shows the share prices at a raised value greater than the book value. Now, when it came into existence, so this tax terminology is firstly introduced in the Union Budget of 2012 by then Finance Minister Pranab Mukherjee to arrest laundering of funds. Okay, to arrest laundering of fund, to check the black money fusion and all such sort of channels. So at that time, this angel tax concept came. Now, another important question, how it affects startups. So as you know that Startup India is a flagship initiative of Government of India and launched on 16th January 2016. Basically, startups are promoted for the innovative ideas, okay, to promote eligible business, okay, for job creation and wealth development. Ministry involved is Ministry of Commerce and Industry. This ministry will consist of Department of Commerce and Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. The recent name is basically Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, and the former name was Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion. Okay. So basically policy formulation and all such channels are properly monitored by the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. It is the new name for the DIPP. Okay. So what is the problem? Let us suppose an individual has an idea for a startup. Okay. Now, when an individual is having an idea for a startup, he needs an investor who is going to provide funds. So that investor is known as angel investor. So that angel investor will purchase an idea, okay, and do investment in terms of fund and accordingly provides premium. Okay, initially the book value of share is very less in this case when we talk about the startups. Okay, now problem arises because many startups have received notices to pay angel tax since last year. Around 80 to 90 startups has received such notices to give angel tax. Now, many founders have said that they have been asked to pay up as much as 30% of their funding of tax. Okay, so this is also the issue. Now, one thing very important you must take care of, that DIPP gave a notification that the business should be sort of eligible startup. The business should be sort of eligible startup. Eligible word is very important to understand when we are going to start a new business, when we are having new idea. First and foremost important thing is that you have to get registered in DIPP as a startup company and have to take approval from the intergroup of ministerial board. Okay. For a eligible startup, you need to have registration in the IPP, as well as you have to take the permission or approval from the intergroup of ministerial board. Okay, so there is a certification sort of thing. Form 1 and Form 2 are available on the DIPP side. Okay, you can go through that. So this is basically the criteria for an eligible business as a startup. And I told you about the problem, which is basically of angel tax. Founders, investors, startup companies are raising the problem. Now, what they want, okay, what startup industry wants. So, you know, that when industry is facing such challenges, so industry would like to address a very important role that startups are facing very high probability of uncertainty. Okay, so industry suggests that discounted cash flow method should be used instead of net asset value method. So discounted cash flow method is basically a projection, okay, projection of assets and liabilities, okay, for 5 years. So that will take care of profit. Okay, that projection is highly uncertain. If company is performing well, it will get a profit. If company is not performing well, it will not get the profit. So then how it is possible to give the tax that is 30%? Okay, so that is the case. So the industry is demanding that discounted cash flow method should be used. Okay, and what is the NAV method? NAV method is basically, suppose if you have to calculate the book value of a share, what you have to do, you have to go through the balance sheet of the end of the financial year, that is 31st March of that company, and try to calculate the asset, total liabilities and number of shares. So you will get a book value of the share. So by that concept, you can get an idea. Okay. So I told you, what is the book value? That is the difference of assets minus liabilities divided by number of shares. So industry want that discounted cash flow method should be used instead of net asset value method, even though company knows, industry knows that discounted cash flow methods are also having a risk margin. That is also a big challenge to take care of. Okay, so some sort of negotiation between company and the merchant, and those things are done. Okay, and they are raising this concern to the government of India that there should be some committee sort of thing to check this issue so that startups can be promoted and such sort of problems cannot be arised. Okay, take the example of the startup like Flipkart, Oyo, Zomato, Amazon. Okay, so what these are the startups, and some investors are investing on them their idea, because Zomato is having some idea, some new idea. So some investor would be spending some money, and you know that if you just see the Zomato background, the history, they are providing cashbacks, they are providing some sort of discounts. So it means that they are facing some challenges. Okay, and likewise, uncertainty is also there. Profit margin, you are getting a proper profit that is completely projected towards your earning. Okay, and that too will take care of your balance sheet. So those issues are there. Okay, now I have last question on this particular issue, that is an exemption available from this tax? Is there any sort of exemption available from this tax? So yes, exemption under section 56 of income tax exemption provision is there. That is, if angel investor funding is up to 10 crore. Okay, if angel investor earning is up to 10 crore, then you can say, if you are issuing share up to 10 crore, then you don't have to give angel tax. Okay, so this is basically all about the angel tax. So try to look after the issue, and if you find any such questions, please do feedback us in comment. We will try to answer you. Okay, and some sort of suggestion, some sort of feedback or important information, you can kindly share with us. Okay, so thanks for watching. Have a good day. And if you just find this video useful, kindly like and subscribe.